The world is full of mysteries. Despite the great achievements in the field of science, we human beings remain clueless about many things around us. Rather than land we live, what seems stranger to us is the ocean, which is home to many myths, legends, and mysteries. While scientists have succeeded in explaining many of these mysteries, there are quite a few still remaining in unexplained. Lost cities, hidden treasures, mystic ships, all part of the alluring marine world. Of all these, the lost city of Atlantis tops the list. The lost city of Atlantis, first mentioned by the ancient Greek philosopher Plato, more than 2,300 years ago. It is known as one of the oldest and greatest mysteries of the world. According to the Plato, the utopian island kingdom exists some 9,000 years before his time and mysteriously disappeared one day. Famed of having been the exhibit of all worldly pleasures in the world, this city is as enigmatic as it is infinite. Even after years of research, an exact truth about this city has not been found, and that adds even more to all the folklores attached with it. Let's know and find what is so fantastic about this city. Where is Atlantis, the mysterious location? The biggest question that boggles minds of the scientists is that where is Atlantis? The narration suggested that the city is believed to have sunk into the sea after the earthquake or tsunami. According to him, the so-called Atlantis was a large island located near the Rock of Gibraltar and consist of the Poseidon Temple and concentric wall and canals. Plato added that the city under the sea should even be somewhere in Atlantic Ocean. However, no technology so far has revealed any such city on the ocean bed. While some theories suggested that the Atlantis is located in the Mediterranean off the coast of Spain, he also argued that it could be even under Antarctica. The unknown size of the giant city. Plato, talking about the mysterious underwater kingdom, and wrote, "For the ocean there was at that time navigable, for in front of the month, which you Greek calls, as you say, the pillar of the Heracles, there lay an island which was larger than Libya and Asia together, and it was possible for the travelers of the time to cross from it to the other islands, and from the islands to the whole of the continent over against them, which encompass that veritable ocean." Tertullian, an early Christian author who believed the Atlantis really once existed in the Atlantic Ocean, said it would be bigger than today's Libya and Asia combined. Tale of God's love. Legend says the Atlantis city was built by Poseidon, the god of sea, when he fell in love with a mortal woman, Cleito. He made this city on the top of the hills, in an isolated island in the sea, to protect her, and named it Atlantis. According to this story, Poseidon walked through the world in the effort to find the biggest island until he reached the biggest of them all, Atlantis, and found it to be inhabited by people who were more beautiful and intelligent than the rest of the world. It was then he fell in love with Cleito, when he find her on this island. The golden statue of Poseidon. The fable tell that Pluto have 5 pairs twin sons with Poseidon. The elder is which name is Atlas. Then 10th son inherited that great city, and the first child Atlas become the first ruler of Atlantis. However, it is believed they also built a huge temple for their father with a giant statue of Poseidon riding a chariot carried by winged horses. The statue was completely built in gold and placed in a temple with its spiral roof so high up that the clouds defied Thor, the spiral the temples. The self-sufficient and rich city. The fertile and beautiful city of Atlantis, where half god and half human beings lived, is believed to have been a self-sufficient region where people grew their own food and reared animals. Farmers in the city used to grow the crops in the fertile plants. They also built beautiful buildings and other architect from material like black and red stone. They also had access to rare metal and even alloys like brass made and used crystal extensively for leisure and experimental purpose, and had a lot of free time even play more volcanoes. So viewer, what about think about the lost city of Atlantis? Please leave your valuable comment in our comment section. Till then, take care and good luck. Bye-bye.